What should I make today?
If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now.
What's up guys, I'm Rob. Welcome to my channel. Now, if you guys follow me on Instagram, you'll know that every time I post a comment or I reply to a comment, I use a lot of emojis because I think an emoji can emote a lot. They're fun and I absolutely love them. You know, another thing I love? Stickers. I absolutely love making stickers and I have made a lot of videos on my channel on how to make stickers using different techniques. And even today, we're doing exactly that. We are making emoji stickers. So get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. Come on, you know that. All right, so let's make some emoji stickers. Now to draw the emojis, I am going to use a bottle cap to get the same size or the circular shape. So here I have a bottle. You just take the cap. Now I'm gonna place this and draw a circle around it. This way, all the emojis will be of the same size. If you're not making a circular or round emoji, then you can just draw the shape freehand. I'm going to draw all the circular shapes, and that's why I am using a bottle cap. This is just for basic reference. I am going to draw freehand on it, so I get a more organic shape. Now that I have this basic outline, I'm going to follow this as a guideline and draw my emojis on this. You can choose the ones you like. I'm going to customize mine with this tiny snapback because I love wearing snapbacks, so I'm adding one to my emojis. Okay, I'm done with my drawings. Now I'm going to color this and then I'm going to draw all the outlines with a permanent marker. So for coloring, I'm using Posca markers. I really like Posca markers because Posca gives a really nice and flat look. But like I said, you can use any medium you like. You can use crayons, sketch pens, watercolors, acrylic colors, whatever you like. In fact, if you don't want to draw, you can just take printouts of these emojis and you can make stickers out of that. But I think drawing and customizing it gives it a more personal and cool look. So that's why we are making them. So as you can see, I'm adding a little bit of detail. I'm adding some shadows, some highlights, so the emojis look nice. I'm not going to add too much detail because I want to give it a nice, cute kind of look. And I'm pretty happy with this. All right, we are done. So you can see all our emojis are ready. Now we will cut them and we will apply a layer of tape on this. Now I'm going to take some sticky tape and add a layer of tape on this. You can see I have some sticky tape here. This tape is 3 inches wide. You actually get them in various sizes. Usually I use this 2-inch one. So you can use a tape that is appropriate to the size of your emoji. Now we'll take a long piece of tape and we'll place it like this with the sticky side up. You can see this is the sticky side up. Now I'll take one of the stickers and I'll flip it and stick it face down. And now I'm going to do the same thing for the rest of the stickers. This will basically give a nice glossy finish to our stickers. Okay, all the emojis are done. Now it's time to cut them. I am cutting all the extra bits out. There you go. You can see now it has a nice glossy finish. If there are any air bubbles, you can just press it down so it has a nice even glossy finish. See, it actually looks like an actual sticker because of this glossy finish. Now I'm going to use a foam tape, which is this double-sided tape. Again, you get them in different sizes. So I have a fatter one here, but as you can see, my emojis are actually bigger than this fat one too. Now you get a tape fatter than this also, but right now I don't have it. So instead of taking a tape which is the same size, take this 1-inch one and I'm going to add 3 rows of it so that it covers the whole thing. And because of this, you'll have a nice sticky back to your sticker and a slight emboss effect. So let's start. All right, so you can see I am done with all the stickers with a double-sided tape back. So now all the stickers have a sticky back, so you can easily peel it and stick it wherever you like. But right now it's this square design, but I want it to be like an emoji shape, which is this round circular shape. So now you can easily take your scissors and cut them to the shape you like. So I'm going to do that, starting with this, and then we'll do the rest. There you go, you can see I've cut the first one. Because of the foam tape, it's slightly thick, so when you stick it on any surface, it will have a slight emboss effect. I think it looks pretty cool. It has a shiny, glossy finish on top and a sticky back. So let's do the rest. And look at that, with that our emoji stickers are ready. I am super happy with them. Looks really nice, and they have a nice sticky back with the double-sided tape, and you can easily peel the tape off like this and stick it wherever you like. So there you go, enjoy. This is another simple and inexpensive way of making stickers. And I think emoji stickers work really well because they depict a mood. So if you're feeling happy, you can put a happy emoji. If you're feeling silly, then you can put a silly face emoji. If you're feeling angry, then don't be angry. Don't be angry, just smile, be happy. Last time when I made a Funko stickers using vinyl sheets, a lot of you said that we can't find vinyl sticker paper and I should figure out another technique of making stickers. So here you go, you have another technique. And I think the double-sided foam tape works really well because it gives a slight emboss effect to the sticker. So this is slightly different from making your regular stickers, and I think they work really well. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and found this tutorial helpful. If you did, then don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Like it, share it with your friends, and please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And if you have, then please subscribe to my new channel, Robin the Hood, where I put up a new vlog every week. So yeah, follow me there too, and follow me on Instagram. Here are my handles. There are two handles, so follow me there. And in the comments below, let me know if you have any more requests, any more suggestions, or I don't know, type something nice. That's the end of the video. I'll see you in my next one. And like I always say, do good and be good. Peace.